You are still picking up the boxes all wrong. How many times do I have to tell you you have to be on point? What am I supposed to do? Do it myself? Watch me. And learn.
What's up, everybody? It's Joe from Complex. We're in New York City at Stadium Goods with legendary supermodel, businesswoman, and the founder of Modelland, Tyra Banks.
What is that? This multi-generational crush on Larry David.
Gonna do some sneaker shopping today. Gonna see what she's feeling, what she's not, and then hopefully she's gonna buy some sneakers.
Oh, I'm definitely buying something.
Let's go.
What am I gonna buy?
Tyra, we gotta start the Little Penny commercials. Iconic Nike basketball campaign. What was it like on set? Yeah. Penny said every time Tyra was on set, it was a way bigger deal.
Was it?
Yeah, that's
I
what
didn't
he said.
Know
he said in an interview, I think, with us, Complex.
Yeah, he was super sweet, very soft-spoken. And actually, Chris was not there.
Okay, just sent in the vocals.
Yes, he sent the vocals in later. So on set, I don't even think I remember hearing Chris. It was like some person off camera, like, stop the car, that's Tyra Banks, fool.
Yeah, you know.
And then later, stop the car, that's Tyra Banks, fool.
Yep.
You know, so it was interesting to see it all in the end because I didn't know what it was gonna really be.
Right, and they live on forever, iconic.
And do you know that I was the first non-athlete to have a Nike contract?
I didn't know that.
That's what they told me.
Okay. Now,
don't be like fact checking me.
Another thing, we were talking about the Will Smith episode, you did a season of Fresh Prince, West Philadelphia, girl who gets a scholarship to play college basketball in LA.
Yes.
But they nailed the footwear Air Force Mid, which is a rare, obscure sneaker.
So approved?
Yeah, approved.
Oh. Where,
was it like a costume design? What was
total.
Because Will had tons of heat, obviously, on the show.
Oh, total costume designer.
Yeah.
Like, she was like, this is what you have to do to look authentic. I had no idea. However, when I auditioned for Fresh Prince, they said she was a basketball player, ex-girlfriend of Will Smith, blah, 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 character. So I went in totally like baller, like big t-shirt, like cut-off shorts or sweats or something.
Yeah.
And I walked into the audition room and every single actress had on a tight black dress and heels. But I was like, oh my God, I made a mistake. I almost wanted to go home, but I went through it anyway and got
the
part.
You got it because of that. You knew
Yes.
it. Tyra, 2006, The Tyra Banks Show. You have Chris Vidal on. Chris Vidal is a kind of like a New York City legend. He used to work at another store, but he was on your show. His girlfriend, I think, wrote you and was like, my boyfriend is obsessed with sneakers.
Oh yeah, she was a desperate plea.
Yes, so you had one of the first pop culture moments where Chris was trying to explain this world, and it was centered around a pair of sneakers, the PlayStation Air Force
Ones. Oh, I remember, yeah.
Whose idea was it to use that as a segment in daytime television?
Well, my producers and I, we would have these meetings every single week, and we would talk about things that were odd, unique, interesting, different. Not so much what was on the pulse, but what was like, what?
Yeah.
What's going on? And so he stood out as an obsessive, compulsive person. And I remember telling him to take the shoe off.
Yes.
I didn't understand it.
Yeah.
And the audience's facial expressions looking at him were like, oh my God, he's crazy.
Right.
What happened?
We have to talk, unfortunately, the tragedy of Kobe. I know that during early in his career, like, he came to LA, he was 17, you said you had a talk with him, but you were also on the hook of Kobe, the rap song.
Yes, I did the hook of that song.
Yeah.
First time I ever sang in public.
And the label got in touch with you. How did that come about?
Well, Kobe and I were at the Teen Choice Awards.
Okay.
He was sitting right behind me. I think I was like second row, he was third row. He had just won for favorite sports star of the year. And I had won for teen's favorite supermodel of the year.
Awesome.
And so he was like, what are you doing this summer? I'm like, I don't know, I'm modeling. And I'm like, what are you doing? He's like, I'm cutting an album. And I was like, you are?
Yeah.
And I was like, I'll sing on it.
Yeah.
And he looked at me like I was crazy.
Mm-hmm.
And then I was like, what if I told you I'd do it for free?
Okay.
And he was like, for free?
Yeah.
Okay.
Sign me up.
Couple of days later, we're in the studio together, and I am singing that hook And I remember the people in the studio kept saying, no, Tyra, your voice is a little bit too deep. You need to be like, more baby, baby, like sweet, like K-O-B-E-I-L-O-V-E.
Okay.
Yeah, and so I did that. And then I was talking with Sony, who was his label, about me doing music. And then I tried to do music, and it was a hot mess. But I remember that. And then we performed the song. Me and Kobe performed the song live during All-Star Weekend on national television.
Amazing. On a lighter note, though, we are in the middle of Curb Your Enthusiasm. Have you been watching?
I have not watched. Is it season 10?
It's amazing. 10. It's an amazing season. I know you're a big fan. You got to catch up. You got to catch
up.
Still crush on Larry David?
I don't know what it is. It's a thing. I don't know if it's his honesty. I don't know if it's ridiculousness. I don't know what it is. But the thing is, my mom has it too.
Okay.
So what is that? This multi-generational crush on Larry David. And I actually, we shared a mutual friend, and I was at a party, and my friend opened the door, and I walked through the door at this party, and my friend just pulls me through the whole house and lands right in front of Larry David.
You met him?
Yeah. And
crush still after meeting him?
Yes,
more,
but it
less.
Was a little, I was uncomfortable, I was nervous.
Okay.
And then he was like, it can't be true. It's not true. I refuse to believe it. You know him. It's not true. It's not true. And almost like he was wanting to do the famous fight with me.
Right,
know, and I was like, no, it is true. But then I was like weirded out and just freaked out. And I was like, this is too real. And I like kind of walked away.
One thing about Larry, he wears very simple sneakers, like low profile. You still have the crush. I have to ask, how much does a guy's sneakers matter to you?
I think my crush from Larry David might go from head to ankle.
Perfect.
Head to ankle.
Tyra, your latest endeavor, Model Land.
Yes.
Very inclusive. It's an experience for people to feel like a model. And one thing I really like, it's like for everyone to get the experience.
Yes. Today, I'm taking that America's Next Top Model experience that was only for a couple dozen people a year and opening the doors of Model Land, which is like an attraction, an experience where any and everybody that loves taking pictures, loves getting their selfie game on, where we take it to the next level. It's not about selfies. It's about Model Land's cameras capturing your unique beauty, and there's also a cathartic, like emotional, beautiful self-love moment at the very end.
You've obviously modeled for every big fashion house. One that sticks out, Christian Dior. Dior, the sneaker of the moment, Dior Jordan 1s. Have you seen these?
No.
So everyone's going crazy over them. They released, I think, in April.
Wow.
I heard like $2,000 retail price.
I can think back to when I first started modeling in Paris, and the designer for Dior at the time was Gianfranco Ferri, an Italian man. If I went up to him and says, I just want to let you know, Gianfranco, that few decades from now, there will be a sneaker that is worth $2,000 coming from the house of Dior, he'd be like, oh, what are you talking about? Get out of my face, Tyra.
Well, we talked about everything. Now's the easy part. Browse the shelf, see what you're going to take home.
Oh my gosh, I can't wait.
Let's do it.
Okay, I'm loving these.
These were nice, just came out,
I like this, I'm born and raised, I'm LA girl.
Size 8, right, in these?
Yes.
Not to cut you off.
Yes,
perfect,
size 8.
Perfect.
My favorite color is yellow. That has to happen.
Okay, we get those in you.
So this is a little bit of fashion. I like all the different like faux fur stuff going on because you can like take your outfits in different places.
Yes.
Can these happen?
These as well, got you.
So I was coming to the register, I saw these, and I love them because they're kind of like my skin color, and they kind of like go with like a natural kind of thing. So if we don't mind, I want to swap them out for these.
Oh yeah, no problem.
All right, your total is going to be $2,496.50.
Okay, here you go.
Awesome. All right, Tyra, you are all set.
Oh my gosh, this is crazy. I'm so fancy.
Enjoy.
Thank you. Bye.
So, Tyra came through, told some great stories. Thanks so much for taking the time.
You're welcome. Thank you. I'm so excited. I went shopping and I'm like walking out with a lot of shoes here.
Good pickups. Get your tickets, model-land.com right now.
Okay.